What the heck has gotten into the Boston Beer Company, better known as Sam Adams? Over the past couple of years, this stock has rocketed higher from under $150 to nearly $400 right now. And I got to tell you, this is one of the most spectacular comebacks I've ever witnessed. I certainly didn't see it coming, did you? So what in the world is driving this thing? We got to understand these things. Okay, Boston Beer was once the ultimate cult stock. A little less than 10 years ago, a craft beer craze swept the nation. Given that Sam Adams was sort of the pioneer of craft beers, the company made a killing and stocks surged into the stratosphere. This was huge. In 2010 and 2011, Boston Beer had sales growth in the low double digits. Then craft beer started taking off in 2012. Well, and next thing you know, they had 13% sales growth. In 2013, it vaulted to 27% growth. 2014, it was 22% growth. Not bad for a company that's been around for decades, right? But ultimately, the very trend that made Boston Beer so successful was its undoing. As more and more tiny craft breweries opened up across the United States, Sam Adams started feeling like a lot less special. In just a few years, it went from being a red-hot growth property to a kind of a lost brand, stuck somewhere between the mass market and the artisanal market. Company sales growth slowed to just 6% in 2015, and then, well, it turned negative, as you can see from the stock, in 2016 and 2017, hence the decline right there, all right? Then beer went out of style, and that only made things more difficult. Throughout this period, the stock got clobbered, which is why I gave up on it a long time ago. I never liked that kind of beer anyway. I mean, to me, it tastes like Cheerios. I don't know about you guys. And that's what makes Boston Beer's comeback so stunning. I think this is an important story because it shows you how companies that were written off and left for dead can indeed make themselves relative again if they have great management. So how do they do it? Now, it starts at the beginning of 2017 when the Boston Beer longtime CEO, Martin Roper, announced his retirement. Now, given the stock's performance over the previous couple of years, I mean, you can see it was time for Roper to go. It took a while for the company to find a permanent replacement. But in February of last year, they brought in a fellow by the name of Dave Berwick. He's the former CEO of Pete's Coffee. Meanwhile, the company founder, Jim Cook, has stayed on as chairman the whole time. Now, I don't want to give all the credit to Berwick. That'd be wrong, because the turn at Boston Beer really had started before he took over. Although, even then, he was a member of the board of directors. In the dark days of 2017, when its growth was shrinking, Boston Beer took a stand, a gutsy stand. Rather than focusing on cost cuts and buybacks to boost earnings, we've seen that playbook a lot, right? They chose to sacrifice near-term profitability in order to invest in the business, something that a lot of executives are afraid to do because it causes their stock to get hurt initially. And then they did it with the hope that these eventually investments would pay off. Boston Beer upped its marketing budget. They invested in new product development, especially outside of the now struggling beer category. The company already had some non-beer products like Twisted Tea and Angry Orchard Cider, but these brands were an afterthought compared to the various formulations of Sam Adams. Now, in retrospect, investing in innovation was a very smart move. In 2017, Boston Beer rolled out a new hard seltzer brand. It was called Truly, which has now become the pillar. Look at this Truly amid, the pillar of the turnaround right here. More on seltzer in a minute. Boston Beer understood that you can't be a growth company unless you're willing to spend money to improve your business. They weren't willing to remain hostage to the fickle beer market. Instead, they took control of their own destiny. Now, why doesn't everyone do this? Because it's too risky, people. Far easier to just stop the bleeding, cut costs, accept your fate as a slow but steady grower. I mean, isn't that like the Kraft Heinz way of working yourself out of a jam? If Boston Beer's investments hadn't paid off, or also Molson, I should say, if Boston Beer hadn't paid off, the stock would have been in big trouble. Hey, it's the nature of the business. Now, it took a while, but by April of last year, people were starting to believe in the story again. And that's when Boston Beer reported a huge earnings beat driven by the non-beer business category. That's Angry Orchard and Twisted Tea. And the new Truly. This is what's known as hard seltzer. I mean, how did they think of this? I don't even know. This is wild berry. It's got 5% alcohol. The key metric in the spirits industry is called depletions, shipments to retailers. And Boston Beer's depletions were up 8%. And that translated to almost 18% revenue growth. That's a fabulous number. The core Sam Adams brand remained weak, but it was more than offset by the strength of the rest of the company, particularly Truly. From there, the stock exploded higher, running straight from 200 to 300 by the end of last June. Of course, it hasn't all been smooth sailing. Boston Beer had some stumbles as they got their turnaround on track, and its stock really got nailed in the fourth quarter as the whole market melted down. But quarter after quarter, management told the same story. Twisted Tea was on fire, Angry Orchard red hot, and the hard seltzer is smoking. Last October, they said this category was set to triple. 3/4 of the market is controlled by two brands, Boston Beer's Truly and White Claw, from the company behind Mike's Hard Lemonade. Even after its fabulous run in 2018, there's still plenty of doubters. For example, UBS initiated coverage of Boston Beer last December with a sell rating and a 228 price target, arguing the stock was too expensive, and sooner or later, the growth was bound to slow. Given that the stock's up more than 60% for 2019, can I call that call premature? I don't want to give anyone a hard time, although, you know, at this point, because I missed it too. But they keep proving the skeptics wrong, and you're not today to sell it every step of the way. Now, in April, Goldman Sachs, good analyst, downgraded the stock to a sell. And then a couple of weeks later, Barron's ran a happy hour could be over for Boston Beer stock. Once again, when Boston Beer reported later that same month, they shot the lights out. In fact, the company literally doubled Wall Street's earnings estimates, making just over $2. Analysts paid them for a buck. Even though management left their full-year guidance unchanged, the results were phenomenal across just every line. Once again, the new products were the big drivers, although this time Dave Burwick really focused on Truly. He said, Truly continues to grow beyond our expectations, all right? We're expanding distribution across all channels and improving our position as a leader in hard seltzer as more competitors enter the category. It was a very bullish story, so bullish that when the other big innovator in the beer business, Constellation Brands, reported the other day, management was peppered over and over with questions about when they'll launch their own spiked seltzer. The analysts, they're jonesing for Truly. In response, the stock quickly spiked back to $320. Look at this. Remember, everybody hate, you know, a lot of guys calling the top right here and went to $320. And since then, it's just kept running, especially when the whole market rolled over May. Earlier this week, Boston Beer broke out above $400. Look at this, will you? This is an incredible move. All right, it's pulled back to 390 as of today, but that is one magnificent run. Now, Boston Beer reports this next quarter exactly 1 week from today. I think you got to be careful about trying to game a quarter because this stock's run so much. But last week, Guggenheim raised its price target of Boston Beer to 421. They argue we could be looking at years of successful growth here thanks to Truly. At Truliers, and there could be even more upside if the company can turn around Sam Adams' brand or get some of its newest brands to take off like Wild Leaf or Tura. I thought Tura was like a car system. Anyway, Guggenheim's also bullish about the company's recent acquisition of Dogfish Head, the rapidly growing craft brewery, for $300 million. Maybe it can turn that around that beer, the beer business. It's very hard to do. The problem, at these levels, the stock's trading at 39 times next year's estimates, which is super expensive, particularly for a beer company. Seems way out of whack. I like Boston Beer. I don't want you to chase it. So what's the bottom line? Losing stocks can become winners again when bold management makes smart decisions and bites the bullet. At this point, Boston Beer's run so much that I think it could sell off hard next week. And obviously, if Constellation comes out with a hard seltzer, this thing's going to go down. If it reports a good quarter, though, we got to take a look. If that happens, use the weakness to do some buying. Otherwise, keep your bat on your shoulder and wait for another pitch. But you know what? I got to hand it to these guys. They've reinvented the company, and they've done it in spectacular style. Let's go to John in Virginia. John.
Hi, Cramer. My son has a question about his stock.
Sure.
Booyah, Mr. Cramer. We have family Cramer night at our house, and I just got General Mills stock for my 15th birthday because I eat a lot of Lucky Charms. What are your thoughts on the stock?
They had a decent quarter. The stock had run up very big in anticipation, so it didn't take off. But I think that it's time for them. You're absolutely right to do it. I want you to put away. Don't trade the thing. Congratulations, John, for doing the right thing. And I love families that invest and take a long-term view, and he knows what he's doing. Okay, listen, Boston Beer could have a sell-off next week. If that happens, you might want to use the week to do some buying. There's much more Mad Money ahead, from Smokestack Company to Smoke Show Stock. I'm talking about Parker Hannifin. And are the banks finally back? I'm crunching the numbers and giving you my take. And all your calls rapid fire in tonight's edition of the Lightning Round. So stick with Cramer.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag mad tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.